As a human race, we face a major challenge. If we are to move and feed 10 billion people on our planet by 2050 and do this within the limits of the planet. As Bühler, we decided that a major contribution we could make was to support our customers to reduce their energy consumption by 50% and their waste production by 50% and their water usage by 50% across their value chains and have solutions ready by 2025. Now, of course, this is not possible to do alone. And this requires partnerships. And learning how to partner and how to build ecosystems has been a 15-year journey that we've been embarking on. And now it begins to really bear fruit. If we look at the example of biotechnology, now we all know and we all see that with the pressure on land use that we're going to have as we feed our growing population, we need to change how our core products are produced and our core staple foods. And biotech offers that opportunity. Now, for us to do this alone was a little bit unthinkable and such a huge risk. So we decided to partner with great companies to accelerate the transition of some of these industries. So the first one is around cultured food, cellular agriculture, cell-based meat, as you hear it all spoken about and you see, you read about it in the press and you see it all across social media. Huge investment goes into this space. And we said, what's our role in accelerating this transition to see if cultured meat is really the sustainable answer for protein supply? So we sat down and with Migros, the leading retailer in Switzerland, with Givaudan, the world's finest flavor house, we created a new joint venture called the Cultured Hub that will support startups in the cultured meat and cultured food space to accelerate from benchtop through to pilot plant application. Now, a second area that we think is very important is that when we want to build process plants in biotechnology for food, is that we can enable our customers to benefit from all the learnings of pharmaceuticals and the decades and decades of process knowledge there, and bring that to our customers at a cost base that makes sense for the food industry. And so we partnered up with Zeta, a fantastic pharma engineering company out of Graz in Austria. And we've created another joint venture where Bühler and Zeta come together to provide the engineering solutions that will unlock scaling cultured meat and precision fermentation for the food and feed industries. So with these two new companies, we believe we can play a significant role in accelerating the development of these emerging industries that we believe have a very good chance to make the food system much more sustainable in the future. But that's not enough. I mean, you need to have technology knowledge and great partners there as well. So we've also announced partnerships this year with Flotveg, you know, one of the leading decanter, tricanter, solid liquid separation companies in the world, with MMS in terms of membrane filtration, and a partnership with Indeco, which enables us to close that gap in terms of plant-based proteins, going from the milling all the way through the wet processing, the extraction, isolate parts, through to meat analogs and dairy analogs. So that's very exciting because that becomes a one-stop shop for total solutions for anyone operating in that space. And in addition, as we try and help our customers to reduce their reliance on the grid, to utilize their side streams to generate energy, we announced a very close cooperation with the company Vinke to enable us to utilize the biomass that comes from side streams to create and to be used for thermal energy within our customers' processing plants. Now, this is all great, but of course we do continue the ecosystem building. In Singapore, our joint lab with Givaudan is proving highly successful, and we have so many customers coming in, be they startups or major multinationals. And we've also in Singapore worked closely with Big Idea Ventures and with the local government to ensure that we can support startups in that ecosystem and attract them to Singapore. In China, we have the innovative Protein Industry Association, which is coming together to support this transition into plant-based and cell-based and fermentation-based protein sources. In North America, we've just announced that we're joining MISTA and we're building up our facility there to work with partners. And this, of course, gives multiple sites across North America where we have extrusion lines and capability and trained staff who can support startups on their journeys and support our customers on their journeys. And in Europe, we work very closely with Mass Challenge, who are now going from strength to strength with a major focus on climate impact and sustainable food systems, and are attracting more and more startups from over the world every single year. Now, we brought all this ecosystem together last year at our networking days. And our networking days is effectively where we pull together a huge customer set, inspirational speakers and partners. We had over 1,000 customers and partners coming here to Uzwil, and we make our ecosystem available to them, and we look at what we as an industry have to do in order to tackle the pressing problems around food systems, around mobility, and how this interacts and impacts climate change, how this impacts biodiversity, and how it impacts social equality. So we're going to continue this year looking for new solutions that will contribute to the 50% reduction targets that I spoke about at the beginning. And we will do this through partnerships, because we're convinced that only through partnerships will we drive change fast enough. We will have access to the broad range of knowledge and capability that is required, and we will bring impact on a timescale that is relevant to ensure a good quality of living for the next generation.